No, there, we got it out of our system. No. Welcome to the worship service this weekend and on this day, and we especially welcome to those that are online, as truly God has loved us, cared for us, and continues to forgive us, and truly as we take this opportunity to worship and praise, and yes, to celebrate. I had to pause there, didn't I? Uh-huh. And make. Who? I think we're all in the holiday weekend, so just hang on. Truly, it is that time where we do get a chance to celebrate and recognize on this Memorial Day weekend really those who have lost their lives and who have fought on our behalf so that we're able to take and gather here and worship this day. Again, the missing man table is set out in the narthex, and I encourage you just to remember one of the reasons why we do have this time where we're able to take and recognize those who have gone before for this Memorial Day weekend. I note that next weekend, as we do a few other announcements, next weekend we will be having our food drive for the food pantry, so please make note of that for next weekend. Why Me God, the cancer support group, there is still space available that Pastor Rab is doing, a $25 donation for those who are in the midst of cancer and would really need and would want to have that new support, that support that comes from that promise of literally that God is with them in their struggle. Please sign up in the church office. The first session will be a week from Monday, June 3rd, from 10:30 to noon. Classic movies at Desert Sky Theater. The Food Fun Fellowship team basically went to the movie theater in town and said, hey, how about if we get together a time where you're able to take and do a classic movie Monday afternoons, first and third Mondays at 1 p.m., $5. Or you can really splurge for all us cheap guys, $11, and you get a small popcorn, small drink that literally is able to take and celebrate that day. So we'll be seeing that first and third. Chicago is the first one that's going to be held, again, starting on June 3rd. On Tuesday, June 4th, we're going to be having, again, the blood drive here with the Red Cross. Please go online and make your appointment with them. Of course, with all things, if you have any questions, you can always call the church office. And just a reminder that Christine, who's normally at the front desk, basically we're going to give her the 2 months off. And so all of those ticket buyings happen Monday through Friday through regular business hours. I think that's all the announcements. And so let's take a moment now and begin and continue with an opening prayer. Almighty God, we come this day filled with that knowledge that you are always with us. Lord, our nation recognizes this weekend as Memorial Day weekend. Help us, Lord, to understand that freedom that we enjoy as we continue to worship you was not without cost. Lord, we do pray this day for all those who are traveling. May they have that safe journey, both to their destination and returning home. Watch over them always, as truly, Lord, we are all your children. Be with our worship this night, God, as we continue to praise you for all that you have continued to do for us, filling our hearts with that sense of forgiveness and the grace and the hope that comes from believing in you. Be with us this day as we lift up our praises and our singing, our songs, and hearing your words of encouragement and life. This we do, O God, because you have come into the world. You have sent your Son so that we might know your care and your promise and your presence for our life. May this service be a blessing for those in the sanctuary and those online as we lift up our voices in praise to you. In your Son's name we pray. Amen. We sing our opening song.
Little children, do not worry. You still got lots of time. There's no need in walking backwards. Turn around and rise and shine. If the load always seems heavy and you're always left behind, pick yourself up from the ground. Jump right back and rise and shine. Rise and shine in the early morning. Shine your light out through the day. Makes no difference what they tell you. Stand right up and have your say. 'Cause the good Lord said he loved you, and through him your strength you'll find. Even though the world may use you, turn around and rise and shine. Look at how they did for Jesus, why they nailed him to the cross. He died out there on Calvary so the world would not be lost. So no matter how they treat you, if they slap you in the face, just remember Jesus loves you, and on that cross he took your place. Rise and shine in the early morning. Shine your light out through the day. Makes no difference what they tell you. Stand right up and have your say. 'Cause the good Lord said he loved you, and through him you're strictly fine. Even though the world may use you, turn around and rise and shine. Shine your light out through the day. Makes no difference what they tell you. Stand right up and have your say. 'Cause the good Lord said he loved you, and through him your strength you'll find. Even though the world may use you, turn around and rise and shine. I wandered so aimless, life filled with sin. I wouldn't let my dear Savior in. Then Jesus came like a stranger in the night. Praise the Lord, I saw the light. I saw the light, I saw the light. No more darkness, no more night. Now I'm so happy, no sorrow in sight. Praise the Lord, I saw the light. Just like a blind man, I wandered. Worries and fears I claim for my own. Then like the blind man that God gave back his sight. Praise the Lord, I saw the light. I saw the light, I saw the light. No more darkness, no more night. Now I'm so happy, no sorrow in sight. Praise the Lord, I saw the light. I walked in darkness, clouds covered me. I had no idea which the way I would be. Then came the sunrise and pulled back the night. Praise the Lord, I saw the light. I saw the light, I saw the light. No more darkness, no more night. Now I'm so happy, no sorrow in sight. Praise the Lord, I saw the light. I'm pressing on the upward way. New heights I'm gaining every day. Still praying as I'm onward bound. Lord, plant my feet on higher ground. Lord, lift me up and let me stand. By faith on heaven's stable land. Lord, plant my feet on higher ground. My heart has no desire to stay where doubts arise and fears dismay. Though some may dwell where those abound, my prayer, my aid is higher ground. Lord, lift me up.
me up and lift me stand.
By faith on hill,
unstable land,
a higher plane,
then
I have found.
Then I have found.
Go plant my feet on higher ground. And catch a gleam of glory bright. Oh, faith is gone, a joyful sound, the song above on higher ground. Lord, lift me up,
let me stand.
By faith on
heaven,
unstable land, a higher plane, than I have found. Lord, plant my feet on higher ground.
Spoken responsively. To God be all glory, the one who visits us in three persons, the Holy Trinity of hope and love. For there is no place and no time which is without you, O God. For you are the beginning and the end, the source of all that is. For there is no place and no time which is without you, O God. Christ, who became human like us, reveals that life is stronger than death. There is no place and no time which is without you, O God. In the Holy Spirit, we are gifted again and again and are called toward a future in which we are surrounded with love and grace. We worship you, O God, for there is no other God like you. Amen. We will now sing our next song.
I see him in a baby smile. He loves me and I know not why. He's everywhere. He calls me from a world of care. I seek him and I find him there. He's in my heart, I feel him there. He's everywhere. Through storms of fear, my eyes were blinded by the veil. I saw no beauty anywhere in anything. Then I drew near the cross where he, in pain and sorrow, died for me. My veil was lifted and he taught my heart to sing. See him in a baby smile. I hear him in the wind that sighs. He loves me and I know not why. He's everywhere. He calls me from a world of care. I seek him and I find him there. He's in my heart, I feel. He loves me and I know not why.
Today's first scripture reading is from Romans chapter 8. Paul writes, "Therefore, brothers and sisters, we have an obligation, but it's not to the flesh, to live according to it. For if you live according to the flesh, you will die. But if by the Spirit you put to death the misdeeds of the body, you will live. For those who are led by the Spirit of God are the children of God. The Spirit you received does not make you slaves, so that you live in fear again. Rather, the Spirit you received brought about your adoption to sonship. And by him we cry, Abba, Father. The Spirit himself testifies with our spirit that we are God's children. Now, if we are children, then we are heirs, heirs of God and co-heirs with Christ, if indeed we share in his suffering, in order that we may also share in his glory." The word of the Lord.
Standing alone with the mountains and the sea, where the arms of the world open wide, where the truth is as plain as the falling rain, and as sure as the time and the tide, you know we're all his children, next of kin. That's the way it began. No matter where you're going or where you've been, you're part of the family of man. When you walk down the road and the sun is on your side, with the sweet river breeze for your face, though you don't hear a sound as you look around, everything sort of falls into place. You know we're all his children, his next of kin. That's the way it began. No matter where you're going or where you've been, you're part of the family of man. That's the way it began. No matter where you're going or where you've been, you're part of the family of man.
Today's second scripture reading is from the Gospel of John, chapter 3. Now there was a Pharisee, a man named Nicodemus, who was a member of the Jewish ruling council. He came to Jesus at night and said, "Rabbi, we know that you are a teacher who has come from God, For no one could perform the signs you are doing if God were not with him. Jesus replied, "Very truly I tell you, no one can see the kingdom of God unless they are born again." "How can someone be born when they are old?" Nicodemus asked. "Surely they cannot enter a second time into their mother's womb to be born." Jesus answered, "Very truly, I tell you, no one can enter the kingdom of God unless they are born of water and spirit. Flesh gives birth to flesh, but the spirit gives birth to spirit. You should not be surprised at my saying, 'You must be born again.' The wind blows wherever it pleases. You hear its sound, but you cannot tell where it comes from or where it is going. So it is with everyone born of the Spirit." "How can this be?" Nicodemus asked. "You are Israel's teacher," said Jesus, "and do you not understand these things? Very truly I tell you, we speak of what we know, and we testify to what we have seen. But still, you people do not accept our testimony. I have spoken to you of earthly things, and you do not believe. How then will you believe if I speak of heavenly things? No one has ever gone into heaven except the one who came from heaven, the Son of Man. Just as Moses lifted up the snake in the wilderness, so the Son of Man must be lifted up, that everyone who believes may have eternal life in him. For God so loved the world that he gave his one and only Son, that whoever believes in him shall not perish, but have eternal life. For God did not send his Son to the world to condemn the world, but to have the world through him." The Gospel of the Lord.
Beloved people of God, may the Holy Spirit fill you this day, both here in sanctuary and for those online this day. Amen. Jerry stood with a realization that his 42 years at the company were about to come to an end. There he is, facing the uncertainty of the future. Those around him told him he was entering his golden years. But what he felt like, he was entering into the emptiness of the future. Jerry had spent 42 years of his life there at the company. That's all he knew. And now all that was coming to an end. You quickly discovered that him and his wife Margie did not have the most connected relationship, that they had grown apart over their 47 years of marriage. And now they looked at each other and wondering, what will the future bring? Their children bought Jerry a boat, hoping that he could just fill his time going fishing. But we soon discovered that that boat could not fill Jerry's time. We now see Jerry at a coffee shop drinking a dollar cup of coffee. And as Jerry's sitting there at the booth, he notices an ad for the local lottery that the state ran. And as he's looking at the ad, he discovers something unique. See, Jerry, though he wasn't always the best with relationships, knew math. And as he looked at the ad, he realized that the lottery had made a mistake, that there is a flaw in their calculation, that there is an opportunity to win if you know how to play. And now begins the adventure. Jerry moves $2,000 out of his bank account and goes and buys 2,000 tickets. He wins a little bit, but he doesn't win very much, and he's a little disappointed when he realized it wasn't a big enough sampling. He needed to buy more, so he takes out almost all the money he has in his bank account and goes and buys tickets. He doesn't tell his wife. because Jerry's very conservative, and this was out of character for him. But she discovers what he's done. And she also discovers that that investment had paid off. And now Jerry and Margie began this journey of playing the lottery in such a way that they would win a little bit more each and every time. But it doesn't stop there. What we discover is that the town in which Jerry and Margie live in, this small little town in Michigan, has seen better days. As Jerry lost his job at the plant, so too have many others. And the town now is in depression. Many of the downtown stores have closed. Many of those business owners had lost their business. And the town was just in a sense of depression like Jerry. And we're told that when Margie and Jerry came back into the town, they looked around and said, "We can make a difference. We can invite others to come and join us, and we can make this town once again be a successful town, a town that we all feel good about." And so they began this journey, not just of them, but the whole town, gathering and using their resources to invest in one another. As the movie goes on, Jerry and Margie go large. Well, we discover in a critical point in the movie where Jerry realizes he can no longer do what he's been doing. He's been shut down. All that they had hoped for is lost. When Jerry gets invited to come to the town hall to meet all those people he had promised, he was afraid that they would be mad at him. He was afraid that they would be disappointed in him, that he did not do all that he had promised them. But what Jerry discovers is not their anger, but what he discovers that they have now invested in him. And the story continues, and the town continues to grow. We discover in this simple movie, this true story of Jerry and Margie, that when they were willing to invest in people, their life took on a whole new meaning. That they discovered it wasn't about the little winnings of the lottery. It was about how they invested in one another. And in that investment, they found life and hope and a purpose to go on each day. Well, sisters and brothers in Christ, today I want to tell you that God has invested in you. That's what this weekend that we celebrate Holy Trinity. It's not about explaining the Trinity, because you can't explain the Trinity. Three in one, one in three. But what you can discover in the Trinity is how God invests in creation and God invests in you, because we believe in a God who invests God's love. We hear the Father loves the Son, who loves the Holy Spirit. The Holy Spirit loves the Father, who loves the Son. The Son loves the Holy Spirit. They are constantly investing in one another, in the relationship they have with one another, the investment of love. And sisters and brothers in Christ, today God reminds you that God has invested in you. His love, his presence. The Apostle Paul tells us this day that God has chosen to adopt you. To adopt you. Just like God chose to adopt the people of Israel, God has now chosen to adopt you out of God's love, out of God's investment in the world. Remember, John says, God so loved the world. God so loved the world that he sent the Son to invest. He invested himself in the very brokenness of this world so that we might have life. That we believe and trust and celebrate this day a God who invests in love. In love in his creation, his love for each and every one of us. That you did not choose God, God chose you and has adopted you so that you may know that your life has meaning. Just like Jerry and Margie, when they invested in their neighbors, they discovered healing and hope, so too when we remember we have been adopted. Not because we have done something amazing, not because we are worthy, but because God has chosen. Because we trust in a God who invests in God's creation, with God's love, with God's grace. That's the power of the Trinity. We see in God this mystery of love. The love the Father has for the Son and the Spirit, and the Spirit to the Father and the Son. It is that constant movement of love that God now flows out to us in His Son. It is that investment God has made in you. And that's why the Apostle Paul says, we as people of faith, we who understand that we have adopted, should not live by the flesh. And what the flesh means, not just, it's not our bodies, it's the flesh understanding of those voices that go off in our heads who tell us we're not enough. You know those voices, don't you? Those voices that remind you. Those voices that reminded Jerry, you were 42 years at this company, now you're nothing. Those voices that keep reminding us that we're not like our siblings or our neighbor. Those voices that remind us of our failures, of our brokenness, of our missed opportunities. We all have those voices, don't we? We all have those voices that keep dragging us back down, telling us we are not lovable. Telling us that we don't matter. And if you live by those voices, you are bound by those voices. You are in bondage to those voices that go off over and over and over again. That is why the Son came to set us free from those voices and to hear the voice of God. You are my child. I have adopted you. I have claimed you. I have marked you. I have invested everything in you. Think about that. Think about the God of the universe. The God that created everything that we see, everything we know, even the things we don't yet know, wants to spend time with you. Loves you. Wants to invest his love in you so that you may live the abundant life God has created you to live, so that you may be the very image of God to the world. That is what God promises us. That's what grace is God's unmerited, undeserving love, God's investment in you. And like, unlike us who expect a rate of return, unlike us who look at, well, what's the future hold? What should I expect back? All God wants is you. All God wants is a relationship with you. All God wants is you to trust God enough to stop listening to those voices and listen to His voice. His voice that tells you you are His beloved. His voice that tells you He has invested everything in you so that you may live life and be freed from that which holds you back. Sisters and brothers, don't we need that kind of investment in our lives? Don't we all wonder at night when those voices go off? Haven't we all been haunted by those things we should have done, could have done, wish we had done? Aren't we all haunted by memories and missed opportunities? Well, today, Jesus wants to set you free. Jesus does not want you to be bound by those things of the flesh. Jesus wants you to know His investment in you. God so loved the world. God so loved you. He gave His life for you. He invested everything for you. And now we get to invest in one another. Think about those people in your life who have invested in you. Think about parents or grandparents, aunts and uncles, neighbors, teachers, coaches, who have invested time and energy in you so that you could become what they saw in you. Maybe they saw in you something that no one else saw. They were willing to take a risk on you because they believed that you could be something more than all those voices that were telling you you could be. Well, God sees in you what he created, and it is good. God knows you are more than the voices that go off in your head, the voices that we are reminded of each day of our lives. God knows who you really are and wants you to be that, because God is invested in that. And God wants us to allow other people to hear, to know that they too matter. You know, there is an epidemic in our country of loneliness. Whether that's from a teenager or a young child all the way up to the later years of our lives, loneliness has become a reality for so many. And there are so many who believe those voices that go off in their heads. There are so many who believe that they don't matter. They need someone to invest time and energy in them. And we have the message and the good news that we believe and trust in the God who is there to invest in their lives. That they are not alone. And that there is a body of Christ who is willing to take the time to invest in them. To see beyond the brokenness of their lives and see the deep richness that God created in them. What a gift. And sisters and brothers, we are the body of Christ who can do it, because we trust in a God who invests in the world, who does not want us to live in loneliness, but wants us to live in community. A God who is willing to take on our pain so that we may find hope and healing. So if you'd like to dig a little deeper today, I invite you to think about this. Does your self-talk motivate you to live out your life-giving values? Or does it put more demands on you and drain you of life? Does that voice inside of you tell you you're not enough? Does that voice inside you always remind you how you don't compare? Well, today, sisters and brothers, I invite you to stop listening to that voice and listen to God's voice. The one who calls you out of your tomb to live life. The one that calls you are my beloved, and I am well pleased. The one who invites you to live life in the spirit and leave the flesh behind so that you may be free. Free to live life, because you have a God who has invested everything in you. Amen.
His mighty arms, my Lord is in command. Sweet loving word, on faith I will stand. He wakes me every morning, his sweet words on my mind, with a heart full of joy and bigger. I know he'll never leave me. He calls me by my name. Sweet loving word of truth to proclaim. Sweet loving word that holds me in his will. He gave his life that everyone might live. He's the open gate, so man can be free. Sweet loving word. walking in a new life, and his treasures are all mine. I ask in his name, he answers every time. Promises of God won't ever fail. Sweet loving word of hope in your way.
Continue our worship as together we affirm our faith in the words of the Nicene Creed. We believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all that is, seen and unseen. We believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, of one being with the Father. Through him all the things were made. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven. By the power of the Holy Spirit, he became incarnate from the Virgin Mary and was made man. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. On the third day he rose again in accordance with the scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son. With the Father and the Son, he is worshiped and glorified. He has spoken through the prophets. We believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. We acknowledge one baptism for the remission of sins. We look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
Will I go to the garden alone while the dew is still on the roses and the voice I hear falling on my ear, the Son of God discloses me, and he talks with me. He tells me I am his own, and the joy we share as we tarry there, no another has ever known. Now he speaks, and the sound of his voice is so sweet, the birds hush their singing. talks with me, and he tells me I am his own, and the joy we share as we tarry there, none other has ever.
On this day, when we celebrate the mystery of God, three yet one, we hear from the psalmist in Psalm 8, how majestic is the name of God. Lord, our Lord, how majestic is your name in all the earth. You have set your glory in the heavens. Through the praise of children and infants, you have established a stronghold against your enemies, to silence the foe and the avenger. When I consider your heavens, the work of your fingers, the moon and the stars which you have set in place, what is mankind that you are mindful of them, human beings that you care for them? You have made them a little lower than the angels and crowned them with glory and honor. You have made them rulers over the works of your hands. You put everything under their feet, all flocks and herds, and the animals of the wild, the birds in the sky and the fish in the sea, all that swim the paths of the seas. Lord, our Lord, how majestic is your name in all the earth. Let us pray. Almighty God, we come this day to give you our thanks, our prayers, our gifts of time, talents, and the ability to proclaim your good news to a world that needs your word of hope. God of new life, bring us hope. New to our prayer list are the family and friends of Jimmy Collins. Leaving the prayer list with thanksgiving for healing is Betty Olson. We pray for all who continue to be in our prayer list and for those whom we know to be in special need of your care and compassion. We now silently pray as we bring our own cares and concerns before you. God of new life, bring us hope. Holy Three, Holy One, you are revealed to us as the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. In you we discover a powerful Creator, our dying Savior, and our comforting Spirit. But we also know you as a loving parent, a risen Lord, and a life-giving Spirit. We're never sure of how you are able to be all these things to us, or how to explain you to the world, but we trust that you are God of new life. Bring us hope. Holy Three, Holy One, you have given humankind authority over the earth. Raise up leaders who listen earnestly, speak honestly, and govern thoughtfully. Heal divisions between nations that we might agree with one another and live in peace. We pray especially for those parts of the world ravaged by war and violence, especially those who are the most vulnerable and unprotected. God of new life, bring us hope. Holy Three, Holy One, you promise to be with us always to the end of the age. Surround those most in need of your healing presence. Any who are lonely, all who are grieving, those who are sick, and those who faced economic uncertainty. God of new life, bring us hope. This weekend, our nation pauses to remember those in the military who have given their lives for freedoms we enjoy. We pray you would have us all look to you for strength, comfort, and guidance. Be with all who serve in our armed forces. Bless them and their families, and grant them your loving protection. Let peace prevail among all the nations, O God, as you work in union with people of goodwill of every nation to answer the call to work for peace and justice, and thus to bring an end to violence and conflict around the globe. God of new life, let us now join our voices together as we pray the prayer that Jesus taught us. Our Father, hallowed be thy name. Your kingdom come. Your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. Forgive our sins as we forgive those who sin against us. Save us from the time of trial and deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen.
We pray that this service has been a blessing for those that are in the sanctuary, those that are in line. If this is the first time you've been worshiping with us, we invite you to stop by the welcome desk so that we can get to know you and you can get to know the things that happen in and amongst and around this place. Just a reminder that because of Memorial Day on Monday, the church office will be closed. And so hear this blessing this day. My friends, go from this place in the love of God the Father as you follow in the footsteps of Jesus the Son. May the presence of God be real to you by the power of the Holy Spirit. In the name of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, amen. Please stand as you're able as we sing our closing song.
Beside me, let him take my hand. shall be no pain and sorrow. Let me live in the light of His love. Let me live in the light love can give. Let it shine like the sun up above. Let me feel every ray, every night, every day. Let me live in the light of His love. When my soul is heavy laden, seems like all my dreams are fading. Let me live in the light of His love. For our past filled with sadness, He can touch and fill with gladness. Let me live in the light of His love. Let me live, let me live in the light love can give. Let it shine like the sun up above. Let me feel every ray, every night, and every day. Let me live.
Forth in love and hope. Thanks be to God. Amen. Let me feel